Hello guys, I will kick off this course by giving an introduction and basic idea of Beam. So what is Apache Beam? Beam is the latest open source project of Apache, which is an unified programming model for expressing efficient and portable data processing pipelines. Actually, it is just another programming model for distributed data processing, but with these two highlighted words as its strength, unified and portable. Talking about unified, see, in this era, we have a lot of different use cases in a common data processing paradigm. We do batch processing, in which we process very big files, usually containing old data. Then we have stream processing, which processes real-time streaming data, for example, Twitter data, data from IoT devices, sensors, stock data, etc. Now, in our older programming models of frameworks like Hadoop, Spark, Flink, we have different abstractions and APIs to process batches and streaming data. Like in Apache Spark, we have RDDs or data frames to do batch processing and data streams for stream processing. Similarly, in Apache Flink, we have data sets for batch and data stream API for stream processing. But in Beam, we have one unified API to process both these two types of data. We don't have separate APIs for them, rather we use one unified API to do all types of processing. So, while you are building a Beam pipeline, you are not much concerned about what type of pipeline you are building. If you are building a batch pipeline or streaming pipeline, it doesn't matter at all. Only the data matters, that's it. Actually, if you notice the name itself, Beam word was coined from the combination of two words, batch and stream. The community wants to change the way in which we see our data. Going forward in future, they want the data to be seen as data only and not into batches and streams. This is one strong point and the vision of Beam, and in fact, the main reason of why this project was started. We are going to learn more about what that unified API is in coming lectures. And if you are very new into this and have no idea of what is batch and streams and difference between them, then I would recommend you to watch a lecture named Batch versus Stream Processing in bonus section of this course. Now the second highlighted word was portable. Portable, as the name suggests, means which is adjustable to all. In Beam context, it means just develop your code and run it anywhere. Beam code, once created, can be run on any of the execution frameworks you choose, like Apache Spark, Apache Flink, Apache SAMZA, Google Cloud Dataflow, and many are in the row. Earlier, it was not like that. You cannot run a Spark Scala code in Flink cluster. Vice versa, you could not run Apache Flink's code in Spark cluster, right? But Apache Beam's programming model gives you this freedom. While we are using Beam, we just have to focus on our use case logic and data without considering any runtime details. In Beam, we have a very clear separation of runtime layer and programming layer. So, create a Beam pipeline and run it anywhere. This portability has one very obvious advantage. As the pipeline is developed only once, and over the time, if you want to change the runtime, like switching from Spark to Flink, or Flink to Cloud Dataflow, or even in future, if any new engine is coming, then you or your company doesn't have to worry about the redevelopment of logics. If that engine is supporting Beam, then the migration would be like a cakewalk. Apart from this, Apache Beam pipelines can be created in multiple languages, that is Java, Python, Go, and many are in the row. You can choose your favorite language and start building pipelines. As a backend runner, currently it supports Apache Spark, Flink, Cloud Dataflow, Apache Apex, Apache SAMZA, and also it supports Apache Gearbump, which is an incubating project of Apache. So in short, Apache Beam is one-stop shop for all the languages to write data processing pipelines and also for the execution engines to run the pipeline. Non-technically, if I say, Beam was started in 2016 and now it has become the top-level project of Apache. Not only Apache, but actually this has become the topmost project for all the vendors. Why? Since it is providing a portable model of building data processing pipelines, so it is obvious that all the companies are going to adopt this model. In case they have to switch between the runners, they don't have to rebuild the whole code. Seeing this, all the runners like Spark, Flink, Cloud Dataflow are working extensively to adjust their systems according to Beam programming model. The priority is this much that all of them are even ready to make changes in their existing systems so as to satisfy the Beam model. Not only the runners community, the programming language community is also working hard to build libraries so as to give support for Beam. Java has taken the lead as of now, They have created a good number of libraries for it. Python is number two. And as the Beam itself is evolving, lot many other languages are starting their journey in providing Beam-based libraries to its users. Moving next, its first version was introduced in June 2016. And this is its Git repository if you want to keep a track of progress they are making. I think that's enough for the introduction. Let's explore Beam theoretically as well as practically in this course.